Fire away.
I don't give a flying shit how I'm perceived. I really don't, and I'm saying that respectfully. You have a right to make a judgment. Everybody does. But how much I pay attention to it is very little.
Do you think that he's deserving?
I really don't care.
John, does the playing spoiler mean anything to you guys?
Nope. It's a bunch of bullshit.
It's always hurt.
What's that?
It's always hurt. Yeah, his game's improved. Always hurt. It's hard to be consistent when you're always hurt. He's always hurt. I can't help but think that, because he's always hurt. I have no idea. He's always hurt.
We have to think about winning games 2-1 because we're just not built to make a bunch of offensive plays right now. We're not there with that team. I don't know how else to say it.
It's self-explanatory. Asking a question you haven't answered to.
What did you see on the fourth goal that stands for
a while? I didn't.
Was tonight an example of that?
You have the answer.
You're asking me questions you have answers to.
What's that?
What did the fourth line bring with their forecheck?
Ask me another question.
What in your evaluation was the reason for the loss?
I'll leave that alone. You're asking me dumb questions, guys. Really dumb questions. Jesus. Played our ass off.
We suck. We haven't forechecked. We haven't done anything.
What do you want to see differently?
Forecheck.
Thank you.
Okay.
He is a really good coach. You guys don't have a clue what he does for that team. I hope he jams it to you all, quite honestly. Not tonight.
As far as language, you can call whatever the hell you want. I know how this coaching staff is going to go about it.
We had some good chances. We just can't freaking score. I'm not gonna replay all that stuff right now. You guys can watch the video yourself.
I'm not gonna be one of those guys that talk about this, that, the other thing, because I don't know what the hell is gonna happen. I think we should shut our mouths, keep our head down, and work.
Well, it's great to see the next generation of Wild fans get invested in a passionate manner around their hockey club. Take a look behind the net at this young lady right here as she celebrates the go-ahead goal for the Wild. She really gets after the goaltender. She lets him have it. Maybe a little bit too much fun. A little censorship there, but again, it's good to see the young fans get into it.
And Rangers head to the power play after that trip, which Rob did not like the call or our camp.
Rebound loose, Zuccarello had a whack, Kaprizov, rebound, and his backhander hit the post. It went all the way through the crease.
Look at that. They ring the post to shift before Kaprizov off the post and out. You got to check the posts for saran wrap. This net looks like it's bubble wrap. Look at that.
Gudas gets the red line. Gudas with a steal, puts it in front, Lundberg scores!
A rare miscue by the Carolina Hurricanes. The Panthers capitalized. Anderson was indecided what he wanted to do with that puck, gave it away.
And there's what the fans were hollering about. It's Joshua trying to get out of the way, wound up at the bench.
Hello.
What are you doing here? Just checking out what's going on in the other bench.
How does this rank for you in playoff pushes, the excitement of this building and the fans' involvement over the last couple of games?
Yeah, I mean, it's been unbelievable. It's a lot better than Vancouver, I'll tell you that for free.
Thanks, Bo. Guys.
Well, he knows what his zip code's going to be for the next 8 years, so why not?
Now stolen by the Wild. Hartman and Binnington. And Hartman gets it by him. And a short-handed goal of all people.
Should I stay or should I go? And with that little bit of hesitation, it certainly cost Binnington.
Hamilton going glass. Turnover, wow. Smith has the layup. New Jersey apparently has no plans to win the Metro Division.
Maurice hasn't got up. They played 10 seconds. He was sitting there stretching down in his crease. This was going on during the play. Working on his hips, the groins, whatever goaltenders do. These goalies, they just do their own thing.
Usually Kaner, whoever he was playing with that night.
Tip it, open net, and he scores. And almost a warm-up shot for Owen Tippett.
That doesn't get much easier than that for Owen Tippett.
Garland across, Kravtsov in front, tipped in. That might have been Seth Jones.
It is.
Kravtsov has his first as a Canuck as Jones put it into his own net, and it's 2-0 Vancouver.
Perfect tip in.
Corner, flipped along by Larson. Over to Dunn.
Just really unlucky here. It goes off the foot of Riley Smith. It's his luck, but unlucky for the Seattle Kraken. It goes right off the right skate, right behind Grubauer, right in between his legs.
Here's Krebs hunting for a point. That goes in the back of the net. Peyton Krebs almost pointing as if that went off the defenseman's stick.
I think it did.
Yeah, and the defender knocked it off his stick, knowing exactly what just happened, but he'll take it.
Barkov on the hop through center. He'll dump it in. Lindgren out of the cage quickly. Charlie coughed it up. Wrist shot from the perimeter. Score! It's Matthew Tkachuk.
And then Lindgren tries to rifle it around the wall. It was closed off by Matthew Tkachuk.
Athanasiev. Tkachuk into the Calgary zone. Markstrom under pressure. Open the net. They score! Athanasiev gets his first NHL goal on a turnover behind the net.
Well, Jacob Markstrom behind the net turns the puck over to Mark Jankowski.
And Shushkin feeds it to the line. McDermott on for Compher. And he'll wire a wrist shot. High one. It bounces in. Colorado takes advantage of a funky bounce to get the lead.
If you're a Kings fan and you believe in hockey gods, stop believing right now.
The word we've gotten on Harrington and his inability to play tonight is the fact, oh my goodness! Prosvetov came out and played a puck and just gave it to Max Comtois, who hit the goal post.
Unbelievable. What a break for Prosvetov.
He was completely turned around, had his back to the play, and that is the definition, folks, of clean living.
Well, we have seen it when Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin were honored during warm-ups in games not too long ago in the past, but it was no different for Chris Letang. The entire team taking the ice with the number 58. 58 jerseys all over, and of course they had to do their best to replicate his warm-up, which included the spin. Yes, smiles all the way around. I think the guys get tens for doing that as they did with Crosby and Malkin not too long ago.
Needs it. Down low. Parfenet. Through the leg. Score! Yes, sir! A spectacular goal! You saw Parfenet.
Out front, it's Nason. Nifty move between the legs, but Sorokin makes the save.
That thing ended up halfway down his chest protector in his jersey.
That was skee ball. That's 100 points.
Beau Drew getting his 1,000th point. That guy getting himself $1,200.
Look out. Sogard gave this away. Got back, made the save. What an opportunity shorthanded for Jordan Staal. It looked like a gift coming from Sogard, who misplayed the puck.
Oh, should you?
No, yeah. You're right.
It ain't working. Look out. Here's a chance. In tight. They score.
Oh, this is one of these plays where when you're Aaron Chernak, you just want the ice to open up and swallow you. He missteps, catches an edge. When he goes to pivot, boom, Sokolov, thank you very much.
Well, you know what, everybody,
second opportunity, third chance.
Freddie Anderson
to the rescue.
Oh, get a puck in that crease.
That's literally on the goal line.
Yep.
Look at the desperation. That looks like a football line of scrimmage or a rugby scrum.
It doesn't get any closer than that.
Look at that puck absolutely rotating.
It heads for the Senators. A rough game on Thursday. They had a good bounce here. They score! Really? It's Eric Brännström.
Well, sometimes it just is your night. And right here, DeBrincat rips this in. He's looking for the hard around, but the stanchion's on the glass, and no one picks it up.
Two on one. Dubé with Uyghur. Dylan Dubé broke his stick as he let go with the shot and got nothing on it. Long-range shot in and out of the glove of Slayman. He couldn't handle the rebound, and they score!
And so many times, that's just an easy one, and Jeremy knows that. It goes right in the webbing. This one popped out. It was a hot potato. He couldn't grab it. Now he tries to scoop it back. Clifton thinks he's got it.
Skips over top, and here comes Pitlick. Foot racer Swayman. Pitlick's got it to the net. He passes, and they score!
Swayman comes out, but Pitlick beats him to the puck, and then he finds Pezzetta all alone in front of the net. You gotta love that. Now Pezzetta gets a goal. He's a fan favorite here as well.
Back towards the floor of the bench where Jeff Skinner battles with a stick upside down in that moment. Gets it right, and now it's Alex Tuck who will carry it across right side.
Swings it back for McCabe. Works it in. Shoot! Scores! Who else? Zach Hastings has done it again.
He told Mark Masters he wanted to get to double digits. Was that off his cap, off his thigh? Who cares? Off the bar it is.
Gibson was ready for it. Dowdy for Kempe. A one-timer. Gibson knocks the net off its moorings. Checking something at the scores table.
With the net coming off, perhaps whether the puck went in. You know, did it sneak there somehow?
Wow. Oh, there it is. There it is. Huh.
Adrian Kempe might have 39.
The shot by LA number 9 fully crossed the... Therefore, this is a goal.
How about that? St. Louis Blues, of course. Reimer behind the net. Trouble! And a chance here for Carlson. Reimer scrambling, got back, but they score. Nicholas Hague.
Well, that one's unfortunate for the San Jose Sharks. Without a doubt, James Reimer as behind the net, James has it. A lot of pressure on him. And then Vegas gets in on the forecheck. James goes down, can't find the puck, doesn't know where it is. Vegas jumps all over it.
Bouncing puck, Giroux. Oh, look at those moves! A two-hopper and a near roll off the back of Sandstrom.
Brought him at Bailey in town. That was a circus act. Kicks up in the air. And here he goes. One, two, and he's off! And Sandstrom makes a head save.
Drew's seen it up. He'll slice one in.
Sandstrom behind the
Debrinket scores! Alex Debrinket wins it for Ottawa off another strange event. Sandstrom the turnover, and Debrinket makes good.
I think it was Corrali and Bergeron broke their sticks at the same time to start the overtime. Is that what happened? Yeah, they both broke. And I don't think Bergeron was aware of it.
Lars Eller playing in game 84 because of the trade. He had a game in hand.
Yeah, Goody, you're right about that. I mean, look at these games played above and beyond the course of a regular season.
We got to throw Tyson Barry in there with the trade, playing his 85th game of the season.
To the cage, bang, bang. Lindgren shuffled over, made the stop. Bertuzzi there, beat it. Look at Charlie! Oh my God, without his glove! Did Charlie Lindgren just make a save without his glove?
I'm not sure.
I think he made a stop barehanded.
Unbelievable. There's that lateral passing. That's as good as it gets, moving the puck around. An even better save by Charlie.
Flyers are 14 points out of a playoff spot. Here's a heavy drive from Raquel.
Up to it! Oh, it's in! It bounces in!
Looking for some luck. The Penguins found some luck.
And it goes off the glass, off the backside of the goaltender. Try calling that one, Cole.
Can you believe that?
Along the boards it goes. Coming out is Aho from the penalty box. He takes it away from the Islander, Sebastian Aho, and he'll draw a penalty. Aho on Aho crime.
For the Aho to Aho, mano y mano.
Number 25 has a 2-minute liner for hockey.
Looks for some help. Pass in front and a great save, Binnington. Oh, and then Athanasio taken down. He wants a call.
He tripped him up. Binnington tripped him up. Watch the save by Binnington. A good one. Now he leans over there. He knows he's in trouble, and he sticks that right leg out there beautifully.
Carter's going to post up in front of Saros. And now up and just goes wide. Somehow stays out. Another odd bouncing puck. Force field up for Nashville.
Carter's wondering how it didn't go in.
That one was actually deflected here by Gravel, then it goes off and then off the crossbar.
That hit foot as well.
Gravel
and to try and settle into the pace of the game.
Granstrom
in front, tipped, and they score. Ottawa's tied it up in a hurry.
So we might have one of these, John, going on where a high event first period.
Well, right on cue, as you suggested. There's another. My goodness, we've got two goals in 5 seconds.
15 seconds left. Mikko sends it all the way down. He scores.
I don't think I've ever seen an empty netter from your own blue line bar down. Mo, have you ever seen a bar down empty netter from your own blue line?
Not ever in my entire life.
That was spectacular.
Kept possession for Dallas. Lindell's shot redirected. Scored! It pinballed twice.
Just a magic puck goes off Kraus, off Pavelski, I think off Nemeth. Oh, maybe not. And into the yawning cage.
Here's what happened. Little contact and their delayed reaction. Vance, not sure what to think as that happened. So the Blue Jackets on ice repair crew is out there.
Pretty quick, they got a hand.
He should, that was almost as quick, maybe quicker than the three goals.
Yeah.
Well, a fine piece of work by Lucas Dostal. It's one thing to stop your opponent's bids on the goal, but how about your own player? That time it was Harrington that trying to intercept that pass and inadvertently poked it right back towards his own net.
Stoley was just talking about playing with Drew Doughty. It's not the same as Matt Boyd. It's a completely different partnership there. So that's what's going on. A little yoga going on in the ice right now. Yeah.
Look
wow.
At that.
It's Warrior 2. It's Warrior 2 right there.
Yeah, nice. Oh, you got a couple back-to-back guys doing it. So
what the?
Just take it. Hey, just take stretch it out.
Kastelic throws it in front, and it's ripped wide of the net. Up but not out. Quick shot. Gillies rebound scores.
He saw that first shot. It looked like he lost his skate blade. Oh, no wonder he couldn't get back. Now he's pumping his way to the bench. That's where he loses the blade.
There, it just came off. It's sitting in the net. And now as he tries to get back, poor guy, just trying to get support to stand up. So he knows he's desperate. He can't push one way. And as he's trying to regroup, no chance on that one.
Jet Alexander of the University of Toronto. There he is right there. He's going to back up Ilya Samsonov tonight with Matt Murray still injured.
And here we got an opportunity. What a great moment.
Just going to ask him.
Yeah, exactly. This is great. Here, Samsonov with a pass on Jet Alexander. What a moment for him with a minute 10 in a 7-1 game. What a great moment. That's your dream to be in this position. Nothing but smiles. How about that? Gotta love it.
Welcome to the big leagues, kid.
What were you thinking when they tell you, all right, you're in?
I was thinking hopefully we win this D-zone draw. That was the first thing that went through my mind. Hopefully they don't get a shot. but, you know, very, very grateful for the opportunity. It's pretty special and something that I'll be able to, you know, tell people down the line. And got 70 seconds in an NHL game, so it's pretty cool.